you're feeling blue. You tell me I don't pay attention to you. But if you want to know just what I'm going through, you wouldn't phone those guys who make me own the jewelry. Oh, when I call you, act a sacrifice. You work your mouth before you dry your ass. I'm not a poop machine.
Power Pop, stepdad in the house. What's going on, gang? Bruce. Been pretty damn busy. A lot going on when you got kids. It's hard to stay up on the game. Been busy, but I got a little bit of time tonight, so I'm gonna come to you tonight with a new thing. Pick three Power Pop. I'm gonna highlight three bands that I really like. Some of it's some obvious stuff. Some of you may already know this stuff. The tune playing in the background is a really popular song for the genre and one of my favorites of all time. So we're gonna get into it here. What we're playing is Back in My Hand by the Jags. It's their most famous popular single. Here's the 7-inch 45 single with Double Vision on the B side. What I'm rocking right now, though, is the 12-inch single. Also has Double Vision on the B side. But the C and B sides would be that Single Vision and What Can I Do? So that's what I've got going here. Got some other stuff from the Jags. Well, first off, this is their full length 1980 Evening Standards on Island Records. Comes with a lyric sheet in her. Lyric sheets there. Great record. Couple slower tracks, but there's no skippers on this. This is fantastic. Off that record, the single Woman's World with the track that's not on the LP called Dumb Blonde on the B side. Again, all Island Records. Another single from that record, Party Games. She's So Considerate on the B side. Island Records again. Both album tracks. Okay. I'm gonna play a song that's not on the full length, but a killer track. It's the same record here. It's the D side of the 45 single. Let's get that queued up. Here we go. We'll play this a little bit. Pure Power Pop. Like my Punkier and Power Pop series. And this, I'm going to focus on what I consider to be straight Power Pop bands. As you can tell, I like loud guitars, big guitars, but something about his guitar tone I think is just killer. Even though it's really, really kind of a clean tone, a little dirty, but there's really not a lot of gain or distortion on it. But they're fun. And I also like the singer Nick's voice and how he puts a lot of words into a little amount of space, but doesn't lose enunciation or doesn't lose emphasis. Anyway, the Jags had a follow-up LP, No Tie Like the Present. Not as good as the self-titled, but still some good tracks on here. Worth picking up if you can find it in the wild. Single from that record. I Never Was a Beach Boy. B-side, Tune Into Heaven, which is off the first record, so I'm not sure why they didn't put two songs from the second album, but Never a Beach Boy again on Island. Good stuff, Jags are great. They're from New Yorkshire in England. I don't know, every time I read these names, I feel like I'm seeing some dude dressed in loincloth at the fucking Renaissance Festival going, New Yorkshire! It's just weird. Anyway, that's the Jags. All right. And that's that. 1980, 81, respectively. Guys never hit the big time, but they should have. I think they're really cool. We get the next band queued up here. We're going to go to US of A for this one. Seattle. I talked about these guys in one of my Pump Your Side of Power Pop videos, but I've always thought they were a genuine power pop band, but they just have the aesthetic of maybe some of the punk bands that they're of their ilk. The Heats, Have an Idea, 1980. No Enter here, just with the label Albatross Records, 1980. Again, out of Seattle. I guess some other bands out of that area was the Moberlys, a band called The Flop. Don't have anything by them. But Jim Bass and the Moberlys, we were a band around that time too. But this is the main group from that area in 79, 80, 81. The other group. This song, I Don't Like Your Face, is off this single. I Don't Like Your Face, Ordinary Girls, is a shot of the dudes in the front. On the back, you got a pupper. Yeah, this came out on a... I think it's Albatross as well. It's that guitar. Cheers. After that, came out with another single, Rivals, Count On Me. Rivals is the better of the two, the A-side, Labels, Big Hole, Heats out of Seattle. There we go for that. We got one more here. Another band that everybody really, really likes and knows. They really don't need a lot of introduction, but I've had people ask me about them in the comments and stuff on some of my videos, and I just never really showed them because Punk Your Side of Power Pop, I just didn't really feel like they fit the bill, but they are a great band, also from the UK, I'm guessing London area, but I don't really know, I could not find that on the internet to save my life, so if anybody knows where they're from, let me know. I'm pretty sure it's the London area. Gonna play another 45 here. This is the B-side to probably their biggest song. Kinda hard to see down here. Anyway, band I'm talking about is the Records. This is the single Starry Eyes. This is probably their best known song. But I'm playing the B-side, Paint Her Face. I just think it's the great B-side. It could have been a single. An A-side, I should say. Now, their self-titled record, The Records, came out in 79. It's called Shades in Bed when it was released in the UK. We'll take a look at this. Gatefold. Ooh, look at the neon. How 80s even though it's 79, right? Ooh. Everybody knows this record. It's into this kind of music, but I had to bring them up and had to show them because I really do love this record. All Messed Up, Ready to Go, Girls That Don't Exist, I Talked About Starry Nights, Insomnia, Affection Rejected, John Wicks, vocalist, one of the main songwriters, the other songwriter, Will Burch, drummer. He was in a band called Kersal Flyers, or Kersal Flyers, I can pronounce that, pop rock band. Recruited John Wicks to start the record, and here we are, so. Now listen to this for a little bit. They had a second single, Tina Rama. I was gonna play this, but a lot of people know this. Virgin Records. Held Up High is a B-side. Another killer song. This was produced by Robert John Lang. This is pre-Mutt years, before Def Leppard and all that shit. Kind of honing his sound, I guess, you know? Second release, Crashes. With all these, not as good, but this is a really consistent, good record. I like the debut better, but this is pretty close. Man with a Girlproof Heart, really cool. Let's see here. The Heart in Your Eyes is really killer. But yeah, here's Heart in Your Eyes single. Speaking of, came off this LP. Also on Virgin. B-side, Heart in Your Eyes. So Sorry is the B-side on this one. There you go. You know what? A lot of fun talking about that. Go ahead and throw Tina Rama on. Right. Said I was gonna play it. Let's go ahead and do it. This is one of my favorite songs by them. So no reason why we shouldn't listen. Here we go. Man, this is going bad. Nah, I don't give a shit, it's fine. I hope everybody's enjoying their Friday night. Don't forget, tomorrow, Halloween Spooktacular, Dr. the Kids, 7 o'clock, America time, Eastern Standard, whatever. Following that, Mr. Bizarro's Hydra Head Series. We're gonna be spending some cool dark Halloween music. Always a fun time, though. Let's listen to this. Jam out here. The Jags. The Heat. The Records. Pick 3 PowerPop. Appreciate you. Love you. I'll try to post another video next week because I don't got anything going on. But for now, I'm going to take off. Everybody take care. I wanted a change of style.